Well, he was a virgin until he's 28, and now, roll tide.
Community, I've had a chance to step back and observe all points of this problem, and there really is a systemic issue that raises, that comes from the way people are raised and the way they are indoctrinated in society, that you are looking at something that's much deeper than just a black versus white. It's really a socioeconomic problem, a lot of it, because, you know, rich people get along, and, you know, I got friends that are below the poverty line, and a fellow I work with, and he really, it's not an issue for him, except when it becomes into personal classification. So it's multifaceted, and it definitely is present on the universe. I was talking with some people a couple months ago, and they said, you know, by the time our generation has grandchildren, they thought the issue of race would have been kind of smudged out of society, because we're the grandchildren of the civil rights movement. And another two generations, three generations removed, they would theoretically be okay with that, but it's systemic and it's ingrained in society. So the question of how to fix it is, you've got to step back and fix society. Fixing society is a big question.
It's great. We have some problems here, you know, understand the sudden accent somehow. Yeah, but Southerners, they're great. And I enjoy some southern food, southern vegetables. I think my favorite is broccoli casserole.
I just never knew that this campus could be so diverse.
My first expectations of coming here, I wasn't too excited, because, you know, I have lived in Birmingham all my life, and I didn't think I would gain much of a culture experience, but truthfully, actually, I mean, you do. There's a lot of different
Us two right here, even though we're in total different classifications and we are a completely different race, somehow I still think he's awesome.
this might be a little abstract, but just roll with me for a second. The world is a car, right? And there will be several people riding in this car who we don't necessarily know. You might be in there with your cousin, a complete stranger, a couple hitchhikers, but we're all in this car together. If we should make a pit stop, or if you should get into an argument with one of them, you would feel like it would be better to just, you know, drop it, just let it ride, just, you know, just get where we going. Everybody just get where you going, you know, as opposed to just discussing it and talking it out with that person. It's just more convenient or easier to deal with if you just, you know, just drop it. You're getting an argument. It's like, no, let's talk this out, man. You don't like me. Why you don't like me? As opposed to keeping it going and making everybody in the car uncomfortable. You know, just like, you know, black and white man, I don't like you either. And then, rather than making the Asian and the Mexican in the front, you know, upset because they arguing in the back and they can't hear the music, just, you know, y'all just shut up and just ride. Just everybody be quiet. And everybody's quiet. I don't think it's because we don't have the opportunity, it's just easier to deal with. It's not the best way, but it's just easier. Cause like I said, you know how they say easier don't necessarily mean better. It's just easier. And we are lazy people. You know, we lazy. Elephants, sir. And don't nobody move, because if, you know, somebody make it too loud of a noise, it's going to be a stampede and kill us all. Straight up.
Okay, to be honest, I think a lot of people are just really afraid to say something, because they think that they're going to be judged by what they say, or somebody's going to get into a fight or whatever. If you like really mature about it, you could be like, I really just listen to what the person has to say. Hopefully you don't get too offended by it, and if you do, let them know in a nice way instead of like lashing out on somebody or just throw fists in their face or whatever. Cause like, I believe that's why people don't really like to talk, cause of being judged or being offended. Cause I will have my opinion, but I don't want to hurt anybody just because of what I think. I think judgment is the main reason why people talk.
Something like needs to be done. done through the university, because I feel like if a group gets together, it doesn't really happen unless you have this, like, this university so big that you need the university backing you in, like, publicity.
And you need, like, all aspects of the campus. Like,
right.
Get, like, people from Shorty Row and get people from, like,
like even like groups like from like the schools, like the different separate schools,
yeah.
Like the business school, like I know there's separate groups.
Like advertise to those clubs, your clubs.
I really hate that about the sororities. I feel like we're so separate. The group is like completely separate. Like I wish that we could join with other groups at the university and like do things to help us or like to like make the university more connected.
I think we're at fault too, because I've definitely been around fraternity boys or fraternity parties or something or functions where racial slurs have been said, and it's like more should be done. There needs to be some kind of discipline, but no, like it's just, I think there are certain fraternities that are more together. I don't know how to say
about. Well, like even some people. I heard, like, after they got the email, they were like, oh, well, that should just be accepted. We're in the South. People should know. And I was like, are you serious? Like, no, it's not okay. There's never okay for racial slurs like that. Like, I don't even want to be called a racial white slur, I guess.
Yeah. I don't like when people, like, say, blah, white girl. I'm like, hi, my name's Haley. What up? Like, nice to meet you, too. Man with shoes, like, I don't know, like... How annoying is that? Like, I'm more than just what I look like. I'm a person, and so is everybody else. Like, it doesn't matter if people look alike, they could be totally different. Like, that's one thing, too. It's like, everyone's different, so how are you gonna judge someone on how they look? Like, there's a lot of problems. Like, I think there's a lot of problems that... I did a speech in high school about blondes, and that just really bugs me when people say stuff about my blonde hair, and I think it's the same about race. And people say stuff, and it's like, what are you talking about? You look really dumb because you're just saying that of an appearance. And that happens with everyone, and that Hispanics, Asians, African Americans, it's ridiculous.
I think it's definitely a topic that needs to be talked about more, and more people need to be open-minded about it. It's definitely something that you can talk a lot, or we just go on and on about, because there's